If it was World War II, and you were hiding Jews in your basement, and the Nazi police knocked on your door and asked if you were hiding Jews, would you lie to them? A common question in ethics is when, if ever, it is appropriate to lie. Some believe that there are white lies, lies that are totally harmless and okay to tell, and others might believe that there are black truths. In other words, there are some things that are technically true, but still wrong to say. One of the most common versions of this question comes from World War II. If you're hiding Jews in your basement, and the Gestapo come to your door and ask you if you're hiding Jews, they interrogate you, do you tell them the truth, or do you lie? I think most people in this situation say, well, of course you would lie. The psychologist Jordan Peterson was actually asked this question in one of his monthly Q&As a little while ago, and his answer surprised me and fascinated me. Someone asked him that exact question. You're in Amsterdam, and Anne Frank is in your basement, and what do you do when the Gestapo come knocking at your door? And instead of answering yes or no, Dr. Peterson said something else completely. He said, if you ever find yourself in a situation like that, it's very likely that you and everyone around you has already been telling a lot of lies. I think the reason why Dr. Peterson was asked that question on his YouTube Q&A was because he speaks a lot about the importance of telling the truth, or at least not lying, or at least not lying very much. And so it was kind of a gotcha question, I think, you know, oh, you know, this is a situation in which you would lie. He ended up not answering the question directly at all, and I've thought about that for a long time. He could have said yes, he could have said no, but instead what he decided to say was, we need to avoid ever getting into that situation in the first place. You don't end up in a situation like that by accident. Almost certainly it's the product of a long series of you and everyone else in your country not doing what they know they should and not saying what they really think. And the consequences of that are exactly what happened here. I'm standing outside the Anne Frank house in the Netherlands in Amsterdam. I'm sure you're familiar with the basic outlines of the story. Anne Frank was a young Jewish girl who fled Germany with her family, moved here to Holland, and when Nazi Germany invaded Holland, they hid in the back of this store. There was a secret annex built where they hid from the Nazis. Eventually they were discovered and captured and sent to concentration camps where Anne Frank died, probably of typhus. Posthumously, she became famous after her diary, first titled The Secret Annex and then titled Diary of a Young Girl, was published. As I stand out here, what I'm struck by is how ordinary this is. And this is just one little apartment building in the city of Amsterdam. There's thousands of these apartment buildings in Amsterdam. Maybe more, I don't know. And Amsterdam is just one city in the world, and there's thousands of cities in the world. The Holocaust and police officers outside someone's home trying to kill them, that's a thing that happened here at one random apartment in Amsterdam. And it's a thing that could happen anywhere. There's nothing particularly special about Amsterdam that means that it had to happen here. It could happen anywhere that people lie and lie again and lie again and continue lying until it creates a whole whirlpool of lies that sucks you down. And it won't just suck you down, it sucks all of Europe down, and that's what World War II was, if Jordan Peterson is right about that. If I was hiding Anne Frank in my basement and then the Gestapo came, I would be very happy to lie to the Gestapo and I would not feel bad about it a bit. But I think we need to take that very sobering warning that that's the wrong place to fix the problem. If you have Nazi police knocking on your door at 3 a.m. That's not the place you want to be. You've already, somewhere along the road, you've made some wrong decisions and other people have made some wrong decisions and you've ended up in a bad place. That's not where you want to be. You want to stop the problem long before that happens so that we never end up in this situation again. Wow, so that's a very sobering topic. Thank you for listening. I'm curious what you think of this topic and the question below. I'm curious how you would answer the question and what you think of Dr. Peterson's answer to that question. It's a little more serious than a lot of the stuff we do on the channel, but if you did enjoy the video, please hit the like and subscribe and check back soon.